been a close advisor and will likely continue to be to the president-elect by all accounts. Also in the room, his daughter Ivanka, who has said she will not be involved in the government. The president and his daughter Ivanka have said that she will be running his business going forward.
I want to bring in Joseph Borelli, New York City councilman. He has been a Donald Trump supporter. Angela Rye, CNN political commentator, former executive director of the Congressional Black Caucus. She was supportive of Hillary Clinton. And Doug High, CNN political commentator, former communications director for the Republican National Committee. Doug High, yes. Ivanka Trump in the room when the president-elect meets with the Japanese prime minister. This is his first foreign meeting with a foreign leader as president-elect. Why was she there? What kind of message does this send?
Well, we don't know, and because the press wasn't in the meeting, there was no press pool coverage.
That's a whole other problem.
We haven't learned a lot what was in there. If it was exchanging pleasantries and introductions, I think that's totally fine. If they're talking serious policies and moving forward with the relationship, how it affects what we've seen just from the past 8 years in Asia, that presents a problem and presents a lot of questions. One of the things that a lot of people have been troubled by, or at least asking questions about, is what is the vetting process, not just for meetings, but for the phone calls that are coming from foreign leaders, and are they on secured lines and things like that? He's obviously talked to a lot of foreign leaders, which is good, but those need to be on a secure line and also following the protocols that come from the State Department.
I mean, Joseph, there have already been a lot of conflict of interest questions raised because it is not clear where the line will be or how the line will be drawn between Trump, his family, and his business. I mean, that's just one. But then, why even have your daughter in the room when that is not clearly, that hasn't been cleared up yet? Well, I mean, why would you even allow for more questions to be raised?
To Doug's first point, Kellyanne Conway had come on the airways prior to this meeting and said that this meeting is going to be an informal meeting between the prime minister and the president-elect. That said, you know, it is unusual in the sense that we have to look back over 20 years to find a president with an adult child. And when we do, we see that Jeb Bush was actually an informal and semi-formal advisor to George Bush, and he has been widely known to have corresponded with his staff. So I don't think it's
Donald
Jeb
Trump
Bush.
Had been very clear that they were going to run the business, right. And the reason he said that is in his view, Donald Trump during the campaign was trying to clear up any questions of conflict of interest.
They're
going to run my business. They're not going to be involved.
But he also said during the campaign that was widely known that his children are an influence in his life and will have a role in sort of a White House as advisors.
But you can't do both. You can't run the business and be an advisor in the White House because that creates a huge conflict of interest. And again, we don't know what happened in that room for the reasons that Doug brought up.
But it was some type of problem.
It was a 90-minute meeting with the Prime Minister of Japan. It could not have just been like the weather's nice, we both like golf. I mean, at a certain point, you know, policy came up, which I know it did.
There are two things that he easily could have done to prevent this this issue, this appearance of impropriety, which is, one, wait until he's actually the president to start having these conversations, which is what folks have done in the past when elected president. And the second thing he could have done was at least get the briefings from the State Department so that he knows how these conversations go. I think, unfortunately, this is just yet another example of Donald Trump's inexperience causing him to make bad decisions. The inexperience of some of the folks on his transition team causing him to make bad decisions. The fact that his three children are on the transition team, I think, yet again, begs the point of his inexperience.
Well, I don't think this is
that they didn't expect to be there. So when the president of South Korea calls and wants to talk to the president-elect, they patch the call through somehow. So the problem is they have to follow the protocols because talking to one nation in Europe before another may cause a problem. Okay. Talking to one nation in Asia before another may cause a problem.
And hiccups happen. Sure. I mean, you've seen this in past administrations. I just don't understand why, when you know there are real conflict of interest questions raised, why even allow it to continue in a very important first meeting that everyone's going to want to know about when you sit down for the first time with a foreign leader.
And to that point,
we don't know there's real conflict of interest issues raised because we don't know the subject of the conversation. And all evidence leading up to it was that this is going to be an informal conversation between the world leader and a future world leader. I mean, we could be grasping at straws to just make inferences.
Remember what Donald Trump said during the campaign? How does Bill Clinton and the current attorney general, how do they talk about kids in golf for however long they were sitting on that plane?
This was a 90-minute meeting.
And as president-elect, he already is a world leader. As we know, he's already saved the Ford Motor Company jobs. He has a real impact.
Let's actually talk about that, because it's fascinating. Donald Trump tweeted last night he claimed credit for saving these jobs in Kentucky. that he didn't save. I mean, Ford was going to change the model they were producing there, but Donald Trump claimed credit for it. You know, there it is. I worked hard with Bill Ford to keep the Lincoln plant in Kentucky. I owe it to the great state of Kentucky for their confidence in me. Joseph Borelli, it's not true.
But no, I mean, if you read the Wall Street Journal today, they come out and say that the Ford company was going to make the escape and expand their operation in the Lexington factory, but they were going to move the Lincoln model, I forget which model it is,
right,
to another factory.
So he won the escape for that plan.
So he got the escape, and now the Lincoln MKZ or whatever will still also be made there. That is a small victory. He's not taking credit for the victory per se. He's saying the president of Ford called him to say, we are happy to work with you in a future administration and keeping jobs here. That is a sort of moral victory. I don't think it's a specifically related to something he did, but I think it shows the new direction that the president wants to go in to keep jobs in America, and I think it is something to be a little pat on the back for.
But they announced it some time ago, one, and I think we have to be careful. There's a separate president and CEO, and of course his name escapes me right now, but that's not who he was on the phone with. He was on the phone with the chairman. I think the bigger issue here is this is a decision they made some time ago, and he shared this information on his Twitter feed like it was something that resulted from the call. I think it's very, very important because, you know, just how when we had Barack Obama, it was all of a sudden, oh, we're post-racial now. We're post-truth. The president-elect represents post-truth. Whatever he says goes to his millions, 12 million
that
Twitter
is the
followers.
Word of the year.
And that is a huge problem.
Guys, we're also post-time for this block right now. Thank you so much for being with us. So, could we see Ted Cruz in Donald Trump's cabinet? The former rivals, they've been working together a little bit to shape the administration, and Ted Cruz himself is set to speak just moments from now. Stick around.